all right, let's try this again. Hopefully I don't back out by accident. But I'm going to be playing NHC Football 14 right now in Dynasty. And we're going to look at the rules and difficulty. I'm going to start off at default, which is 0 for starting levels. And the coach setting in progress is at normal. And the auto name is going to be on. I remember changing the file name probably. And probably not. Whatever. But then we'll go over to gameplay. I'm going to bump this up because I forgot to since I fucked up last time. And we are going to change the quarters to 6 minutes. Everything else should be fine. I might fuck with the sliders after a while. I might make it a little more difficult depending on how things go, but it's going to be normal. I'm just going to set up the default. We're going to go over and we're going to look at the conferences and the way they're set up. I've realigned these to be as realistic as possible. I've been moving around, like adding Rutgers to the Big Ten and also adding Maryland and stuff like that. And I don't even have to look at the conferences anymore to do it. But we're going to go to the ACC. Louisville is in the Atlantic, obviously, and I pulled out Maryland to put in the Big Ten. We're going to go to the American Conference, which is the East and the West side. Navy is on the West side in real life, so I lined everything up to work with that. We're going to go to the Big 12. Nothing's changed. Just the same old Big 12 with 10 schools. We already looked at the Big 10. We're going to look at Conference USA. If you look at it, I didn't take out UAB. And if I remember right, Charlotte is in the east side also. And I did not import them into the game because normally people take out like Idaho or UAB and they replace them. But UAB is back with their football program this past year. And I got something planned for Idaho. So we're going to move on to the independent, and there's Army, West Point, BYU, Idaho, and Notre Dame, like it is in real life. If you look at the MAC, set up like normal. UMass is supposed to be, UMass and New Mexico State are supposed to be in the independent conference. But I moved them to a conference just because I kind of cater to them. They're always kind of like the cellar dwellers, but I always kind of cater them. Put them in a conference just so they stay somewhat competitive in this game. The Mountain West is obviously the same. Nothing's changed. Pac-12, nothing's changed. It's been like that. ICC, same thing. Nothing has changed. All the same alignment. And here is where New Mexico State and UMass are. If they weren't in here, there would be 7 teams in the Sun Belt, which is fairly small. I mean, Appalachian State is also in there now. Georgia Southern's also in there. And I think they're getting one more, if I remember right, this past year. But don't quote me on that. But that's the way I have it set up, just so I have UMass and New Mexico State in there. We're going to go up. We're going to start our dynasty. I have everything set up. The BC tie-ins, I've not fucked with anything in the BCS tie-ins. Here's your preseason. Hopefully this will be a fairly good series. I really enjoy this game. I've been playing the absolute shit out of it since it came out. What's it going to be like? 5 years? 5 years now? 4 or 5 years? I just wish they'd come out with a new one. But I do have the updated rosters. I do that every year just to kind of keep it somewhat realistic. But we're going to go to the independent. And the reason why I kept Idaho is because I wanted to play with Idaho. Just because they are moving down to the FCS this year in 2018. The first ever Division 1 team to go from the FBS level to the FCS level, which is quite sad, honestly, but do I blame them? No, I don't. And if we want to look at their past records, since 2000, this is 2012 and behind, which I think they went to a bowl game 2 years ago. Now, these two 2 years ago, they played Colorado State, and they actually did really, really well. But if you look at it, there's 2-1-11 years. They had an 8-5 year, which I remember watching that bowl game. They did really well on that. And a 9-3, 7-4, 1-10, and that's it. Like, that's all I got. If they only look at it, they have 5 winning seasons, and yeah, 5 winning seasons, and 6 if you count the 1-2 years ago, and 20 years, 22 years, something like that. That's ridiculous. You're gonna see here, program tradition is at a D, which is fairly low. It's a 7-year contract. I never thought they were always this big. I always thought they were like 1, 2, or 3 year contracts, but it is a 7-year contract. And hopefully after like the first year, we can actually be a very solidified program and we can average 7 wins, 8 wins, 9 wins, and we'll just go from there. Because if I do, if I start gaining pretty well, I might move myself after a couple of years to the Mountain West out of the Independent and then slowly work my way to the Pac-12. We're going to go over to recruiting. We're going to select the ever so awesome scouting. I really wanted to start on level 3 just so I had 100% scouting. But I'm not going to fuck with that. The defensive coordinators, what I normally always do is I always go over to the recharge and start with their injury and stamina. Just because I always like having the starters play more. And I think that's what a lot of people do. Is normally start off with that. And my offensive coordinator is Chris Kaminsky. Kaminsky? Or Sinkovonsky. We're going to go with Kamonsky. Sinkovonsky. And then Mike Bruschi. The defensive coordinator, I like that. Mike Bruschi. I really like that. I hope he stays. I hope he never leaves, just because I like his last name. Or Bruschi. I'm going to call him Bruschi. Fuck it. What I always like to do, also, is I go to the redshirt. I'm going to redshirt the players first, just so when I do go to recruiting, that I have an idea what I absolutely need and what I don't need. We're going to go down, and we're going to redshirt Dalen Lee Lemley. Out of Los Angeles, California. We don't have a... Man, I wish his speed was a little bit more, because I am running the pistol in this dynasty for this play of the coach. And I really... His awareness is good. He's got good speed. And he's probably got a really, really good arm. But I do need that speed a little bit more. And I wish he was a little bit more athletic with breaking tackles. Which... Yeah, we'll back it up. But... That's something that is kind of the plus side, is because he can throw. He got good accuracy, and he does have good throw power. But he's slow. Well, that's something we'll come along across. We might have to change some sub-formations. I'm not going to... Ooh, 96 speed? Damn, dude. He's going to be a real good player next year. I'm going to like that. Because after Duckworth leaves, Aaron Duckworth, who's 5'8". God, he's short. He's a little guy. But I like that. I like the undersized people because it's always just something that seems good. We got a senior for our fullback, which is good. We got two deep, which is amazing. Thank God. Wide receiver core, we're fairly thin. We got three seniors on top. Ooh. That's something we're going to have to recruit heavily in the wide receiver department this coming up here. We do got good speed on the top end. We got 89, 92, 91, 89, 89. So we got really, really good speed. I do think the standout person that is going to be this year will probably, I'm going to call it right now, is going to be Jacob. Jacob's probably going to do really well. Jacob Shannon. Tight end, we got great depth in tight end. Thank the Lord. Tight end's always really good in the pistol formations. I'm going to redshirt Ivering just because they both are juniors. I'm not going to redshirt Carlos. Got two freshmen. The line is young. This is good. This is good. Got a senior right tackle, Jordan Rose. And my left end, I'm actually going to redshirt Henderson. DJ Henderson, because I feel like, because he's going to be a junior again next year when he comes in, which will probably mean he's going to be like a 77 overall, 76, which would be amazing. And he'll have still another year to play. And he's got 91 strength, so that's really good. I am going to redshirt Ben Tulu. It's going to be confusing to say. I do got to run the 3-4. Shit. I was going to run the 4-3 because I know we ain't going to be able to stop the run. But considering we only got three tight ends, I got to run the 3-4 now, which is quite disappointing. I'm not really good with the 3-4. Got to redshirt him. And Christensen. I can't because we're going to run the 3-4. We can't do that. And we will redshirt... Is it going to be Aaron or T.Y. Graham? Let's redshirt Aaron. Just because he is a little bit slower. And he can build up that speed a little bit more. Looks like we're very young defensively on the backside. Which is very good. Which I'm happy with. Looks like we're a fairly young team all the way around. Redshirt Barnett. Quindarn. I don't get why I'm trying to pronounce these names. And yeah, we'll just run that demon. How is my punting kicking? We got a freshman kicker. 77 overall. He's probably got really, really, really good kicking power, probably. I hope so. 91 kick power. That's good. That's actually on the good side. So he's got 81, so we can kick some long field goals. And we got a freshman punter. This is perfect. It's a super, super young team. This is great. I actually enjoy this. We'll go to the end of the scheduling and see where we got. We're going to open up against North Texas. Then we play at home against Temple. At California, I'll probably leave that game. At Washington State, that is a rivalry game. And then we play Fresno, which I think is another rivalry. There's a non. Let's see what it is. Boise State's the other one. Okay, I always thought they had three rivalries. And they play at home against Old Dominion, at home against San Jose State. I don't like playing teams in the same conference, especially if they're smaller conference like the Mountain West. We're going to play at Ole Miss. We'll leave that game. At Wyoming, we'll leave that game. Home against UAB, which will probably actually be a fairly, really good game. Home against Nevada. That's three teams in the Mountain West in the same compound. I'm going to change that up. We're going to go up to San Jose, and we're going to change. No. We're going to leave the small schools at home. We're going to get rid of North Texas. Get rid of North Texas, and we're going to scroll on down, and we're going to play... I want to play a California team. Just because that's where a lot of our recruits are going to be coming out of. We'll be out of California. I think we should play... We'll play USC, you know? We'll play at the big house. We'll play at the... big house is Michigan. But we'll play at USC. I'm not scared of USC. We got California, we got Washington State. Yeah, it's three teams from the fucking Pac-12 right there. But it's whatevs. And we'll get rid of San Jose State. Hopefully we can put Boise. I can't put Boise. Shit. Maybe play Boise for the last game of the year. Be quite interesting, you know, make it like that a tradition. Or I could play Stanford. Can't do that though. We'll go on up. Then we'll move. Ooh, I don't want to start off a four-game slate that bad, but we'll have to get rid of it. Boise State. We'll play Boise State at home. Alright, we'll play Boise State. So there we go. We got both rivalry games. We'll play USC, Boise State, California, and Washington State to start off the first 4 weeks, which is brutal. Absolutely brutal. We're probably going to get slaughtered against USC. Boise State will probably be a very close game, considering it is at home. We play at Cal, which in this game isn't very good. So that might be a game we might be able to squeak out. And then we play Washington State, and Washington State is an air raid, which will be very, very predictable. But at the same time, it's going to be very hard to stop because they are very, very good at what they do. Then we play Fresno State, which should be a decent one. Then we play Old Dominion, that's another air raid team. I predict we're going to go 6-6 because we can win. If we win one game and win in the first 4 weeks, is good. You could probably rattle off the next three games from week 6 to week 8. It's right there. Put us at 4-4. We'll lose at Ole Miss probably, and we'll be 4-5, and we'll be 5-5 after we beat Wyoming, and then we'll be 6-5. Then I got a feeling we're gonna fall apart at the end. So I got a feeling we're gonna go 6-6. We gotta win at least one big upset game, in all reality, which we can do that. I believe in that. We'll keep that. Keep this. I like that. It's not a very super tough schedule, but it's not very weak. We play a lot of teams out west, which is good because that's where we're from. So hopefully, this is a very competitive and fun season. Hopefully I don't go 0-12 and get fired right away and be like, yeah, well, this dynasty turns into me being an offensive coordinator for 2 years to get a decently good job back. But I doubt it. As long as I can win like 4 games, I'm pretty sure I can keep my job. So here we're going to look at the recruits. We need 2 defensive tackles and 2 wide receivers, which I kind of anticipated considering we're very thin on both sides. What am I doing? Wow. I always do that all the time. Man, this is long. This is already 14 minutes. Which is probably... I'll probably upload the preseason, and then I'll probably be putting out the next video. Sterling, Alaska. All right. You know what? F it, just because you're from Alaska. Man, I don't get why I pressed L2. Come on. Excuse me. Quarterbacks, University Park, Texas, and we're going to recruit him. I got a feeling he's going to be a decently good player. Running back wise, we'll recruit a couple people. I'm just kind of recruiting for more of like depth wise. We are going after him. We're going to keep at least two deep in the fullback position as much as possible. And us being first on the depth chart with a 71 overall blocking fullback, which is what he is designed to do, is perfect. So hopefully we can get some good recruits, especially out of the California area. If we get like a really good pipeline out of California, that'd be really good for us. Because California does produce a lot of good talent year in and year out. And I don't know where else. I'm just going to go with that. We're going to go with that. We don't need any tight ends. Tackles. He's already 30% committed, but I will click on him just because he is a JUCO, so he might get better. He's 6'5", 307, so he's a pretty big tackle. I don't need any guards. Defensive ends. We recruit both of them. Even though we don't need anybody there, it'll just be nice to kind of have that reassurance. Stevens Point, Wisconsin. That's actually not that far from where I live. I don't live in Wisconsin, but that's about like an hour and a half away. Haley, Idaho. He's a home in-stater. Hopefully we can keep him in-state. Boise, Idaho. Yeah. Just because it's super close to where we live. Let's super close with the campus at. Let's go. Yeah, that's what we'll do. And we're going to recruit outside linebackers because they're always really good defensive tackles and defensive ends. You can always convert them over. Just like you convert strong safeties over to linebacker position. We don't need any corners, but I am going to recruit these two guys just to kind of keep the depth rolling. And free safeties, I don't really need anybody, so I'm not going to recruit anybody out of there. And James Carter, we'll just recruit him because, like I said, he convert him over to free safety, over to outside linebackers and stuff like that. And there is no athletes and no kickers or punters, which is very disappointing. As you can see, we got a very shitty recruiting class, but that's a part of this dynasty and this program. They've never been known to bring in high caliber people, and they kind of just do what they got to do with what they got. As you can see, our pipelines are California, Washington, Idaho, and we're going to lose Florida next year, which is quite disappointing, unless I can recruit a couple people out of there. But I do get one extra pipeline choice, because when you do play this game, you have a chance of like buying alternate jerseys and other boosters and stuff like that. I ended up just buying it all when it first came out because I was super addicted to this game. But I might want to do Arizona. Should we do Arizona? I'm going to do Texas. I'm going to make Texas our next pipeline just so we can recruit some speed and some good quarterbacks out of there. Spark 100. What am I doing? Whatever. The top recruit in the nation is Kenyon Mason. He is out of Ohio, which is 6'5", 234 athlete, which most of the time the athletes are the top players in the nation anyways. We're going to look at Idaho and what their points and what is good for me. Pro potential is a B-. That is quite honestly a surprise. I don't think I've ever... They got one first-round draft pick? No way, dude. I want to know who that is. Proximity to home. Good in everybody's position. I always kind of like looking at that stuff. Academic prestige, we're a C+. The coaching prestige is a C, obviously, because we just started. It'll probably get worse or better as the season goes on. Stadium atmosphere, we do play in a dome, which is awesome. I do like playing in a dome. You can see their career record overall. They are 152 games behind being positive and having a winning record overall. Coaching stability, obviously, it isn't much. Bruski, you're going to sign an extension, I swear. You're not leaving me, ever. Just because I like your last name. The championship contender, we are pretty bad, but if you do look at it, we do trend upwards in the next 4 years. So it is looking good for us. Program tradition is pretty bad. We are undefeated in the bowl record. I hope I can keep that to the end of this dynasty, because I want to be the only team to have an undefeated bowl record left. And you can see we won one conference championship in 1998. I want to say that was the Sun Belt back then. They were in the Sun Belt, if I remember right. They were in the Sun Belt this past couple of years, but then they got kicked out due to not bringing enough revenue in. And Idaho is a long ways away from, say, Alabama and Georgia and the Carolinas. Everything else is pretty bad. The conference prestige is going to be a D minus, obviously, because we are not in a conference. But if you look at the rankings, SEC, ACC, Big Ten, Big 12, the Pac-12, and the American Conference is what the rankings are. Let's back it all out. Oh, crap. Fuck. I gotta go up. I always forget to do this. I don't want it. I don't want my fucking recruiting board to get pile full. If you guys ever play this game, always turn off recruiting board assistance. It determines whether the CPU will be allowed to add or remove prospects, and it's ridiculously stupid if you leave it on. And I'm going to turn everything off because I want to be able to set what I want to set. I want to be able to put people in visits that I want to visit, and I want to be able to recruit who I want to recruit without the computer fucking with me. We're going to choose this extra pipeline real quick, which is going to be Texas, and then we're going to sim forward. There we go. Got Texas as the pipeline. So we got California, Washington, Idaho, and Florida in Texas now. But let's move on to the start of the season. Alright, here we go. Here we go. We're going to start off the first game of the season. That'll be the next video because this video is very long. It's 22 minutes just to set up the preseason. But as you can see, Kirk Herbstreit is going with USC. I hope to God he would. It is at USC. USC is an A+. It is not A+, but A overall. And a very winning program. And they are fourth ranked in the nation. We go down to the preseason polls. See how that's all set up. It's never changed. It's always normally the same. Got Alabama as number one, Ohio State at number two, Florida State, USC, Clemson, Penn State, Oklahoma, Washington, which would have been nice to play them also, Wisconsin, Oklahoma State, Michigan, Auburn, LSU, Stanford, Georgia, Louisville, Florida, Miami Hurricanes, UFC, well, UFC, USF, Kansas State, you got Virginia Tech, you got West Virginia, Texas, Washington State, and we got Tennessee rounding out the very top 25. Leave down below in the comments what you guys will think will be at the end of the season, who will be in the championship game. I'm gonna predict Alabama, obviously, because they're ridiculously overpowered in real life and also in this game. I despise Alabama, but Nick Saban's doing great, and you can't stop what's good. So I'm going to predict Alabama, and I'm going to predict Ohio State. That's my predictions to be in the championship game. And leave down below what team you'll think will be not ranked this year and will come out big, say, in the ranking-wise. I'm going to honestly pick – I want to pick UCLA, man, because they're going to be – they're really good in this game after a couple of years. I'm going to pick them to do really well this year and kind of shock everyone and – possibly cause some noise in the Pac-12. But let's scroll on down to the bottom and see where we're located at. Who's our neighbors down in these rankings? the very bottom is your Texas State Bobcats. And we got UAB at second to last. In Idaho, our neighbors are the Florida Atlantic Owls, who is coached by Lane Kiffin, who had an amazing year this past year. And I honestly think that program is going to be a dark horse these next couple of years. And the one right below us is Southern Alabama. So we get to play those guys. I'm pretty sure. No, we don't play those guys. I don't think we play anybody on. Yeah, we do. Fresno State, which is in the below the 100. But that's who our neighbors are, is Florida Atlantic and Southern Alabama. Let's see where we finish together towards the end of the year. Let's go to the conference outlook and see where they're picking us to pick in the independent conference, which will probably be last. Yes, Notre Dame's obviously the pick first, which, hope to God. Yeah, BYU, who's never really good in this game. I don't know why. You got Army, who will do really well just because the option is overpowered in this game. And there's us. The MAC is probably picked by, like, Toledo. Yep, Toledo's to win the MAC. The Mountain West is probably, like, Boise State. Yep, Boise State predicted to win the Mountain West, which is good because we do play them. The Pac-12 will probably be USC, my fucking lord, speak. Probably Alabama, yep, Alabama. And this one is probably, I don't even know, Arkansas State. Yeah, I should have picked that. They always win that conference down there. And you got the ACC, who is predicted by Florida State. Surprise, surprise. And the American will probably be Houston. No, USF. Wow, that's a surprise. I would have predicted Houston to actually win it all. And the Big 12 is probably Oklahoma. Boom, what a surprise. Oklahoma, Oklahoma State predicted first and second. Kansas to finish last, like usual. And Ohio State predicted to win the Big 10. And my current favorite team in the college football real life is the University of Iowa. And the Hawkeyes, I've always been a Hawkeye fan since I was a little kid, so if you hate on me, I really don't give a shit. I'm always a Hawkeye fan, through thick and thin, and whoever, you can play the weakest conference and the weakest schedule in America, and I'm still going to love them, because they're my boys. We're going to go down to the Heisman now and see who's going to be winning the Heisman, and it's probably going to be Mayfield. Nope. Oh, I forgot. They don't have, oh, wait, what? Well, doesn't make any sense. Connor Bulem, wow. He's a 70 overall quarterback out of Texas A&M. How is he predicted to win the fucking Heisman? He blows. There's a center. What? a wide receiver is a little bit more, but he's a sophomore. And then our running back, which is a little bit more believable. Whatever. Yep, center. Center from Alabama is going to win the Heisman. Calling it right now. Boom. You heard it from me. 2018 Heisman winner. But that's all for today. The next video will probably be coming up in the next couple of hours after this or the next day, involving the game between you, USC and the Idaho Vandals. And let's see how well we can get our asses handed to us. But thanks for watching, guys. Like, subscribe, and comment down below what you guys think are going to win the national title game this year in this dynasty and who is going to be playing against them. And comment what you think we're going to do wise for our record. I think we're honestly going to go 6-6 and get to a bowl game. But we'll see how the time plays out. But like I said, thanks for watching, and hopefully I see you guys in the next video.